This video will examine the front runners for the COVID-19 vaccine. You'll learn how these vaccines work, side effects, and warnings to be aware of. And at the end of this video, look at 6 facts versus myth examples coming up. This channel is about tips and advice to promote your health and to help you stay young. Therefore, think your health and hit the notification bell and the subscribe button as well. This year, there's been a race to come up with a safe vaccine against COVID-19. Researchers are testing 54 vaccines in clinical trials on humans, and at least 87 preclinical vaccines are under active investigation in animals. This video is being shot in the 3rd week of November, and there has been some promising news in the last couple of days. Moderna, a Massachusetts-based company, states that preliminary results of its vaccine suggest it may be up to 95% effective. Pfizer and the German company called BioNTech, which it has teamed up with, state that their preliminary data shows that the vaccine to be 95% effective. AstraZeneca, a British-Swedish company, together with the University of Oxford, announced that their vaccine is 62% or 90% effective, depending on the manner in which the doses were given. Johnson Johnson, a US-based company, has yet to announce how effective the virus is going to be. Final results are expected by the end of the year. So let's crunch some more numbers and facts. Pfizer and BioNTech, as well as Moderna, are developing messenger RNA vaccines. These can also be referred to as genetic vaccines. AstraZeneca and Oxford and Johnson Johnson are developing viral vector vaccines. AstraZeneca is using a chimpanzee adenovirus, and Johnson Johnson are using human adenovirus. And I'll talk about these terms and what they mean a bit later in this video. In terms of volunteers and participants in their various trials, here are the numbers. As you can see, these are pretty impressive numbers for the number of people who were recruited for all 4 vaccine makers. However, just as important is that the demographic makeup of the trials are representative of the communities at the highest risk for COVID-19, and that would be the people of color, minorities, and older adults. There's been criticism by many experts, especially in the phase 1 and 2 trials, where these groups who were disproportionately affected by COVID-19 were not adequately represented in these trials. So how are these vaccines stored? Pfizer and the BioNTech vaccine needs to be frozen at minus 94 degrees Fahrenheit, which is around minus 70 degrees centigrade. Moderna has to be also frozen at minus 4 degrees Fahrenheit, which is around minus 20 degrees centigrade. AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson both can be refrigerated. And how many doses of the vaccine will you need? For Pfizer, Moderna, and AstraZeneca, 2 doses, and Johnson & Johnson, you'll need only 1 dose. The cost of the vaccine for Pfizer, around $20, Moderna, $30, AstraZeneca, $3 to $4, and Johnson & Johnson, $10. I've summarized this information on the screen, and you can pause till the video and look at it and rewind it and keep looking at it. What are messenger RNA vaccines? These are for Pfizer and Moderna. You take a small gene from the virus and inoculate the patient with a small piece of messenger RNA. In this way, messenger RNA enters your body, and this messenger RNA enters the cytoplasm of your cell. This is the area around the nucleus of the cell. Here, a part of the virus is translated to a protein. This protein is in fact the coronavirus spike protein. This is how the coronavirus looks like. This is the spike protein, so this is exactly where this is going to be made in your cell. This protein, which is being made in your cell, induces your body to activate your immune system to build antibodies. The way it does that is that this protein is displayed on the cell surface. In this way, your body has learned how to protect against future infections. When you get infected with the coronavirus, these antibodies stick to the coronavirus spike proteins and in this way prevent the virus from binding to cells. The virus is then prevented from entering your cells and infecting your cells. What are viral vector vaccines? These are for AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson. This is another way to introduce the coronavirus gene into the cell. So how is this done? The scientists use adenoviruses. These are viruses which can cause the common cold. Researchers use these viruses as vectors or means of carrying the gene for COVID-19 into the cell. This modified cold virus can then make the COVID-19 spike protein. This in turn stimulates your immune response and your body can build antibodies. The effectiveness of the COVID-19 vaccines. Like I mentioned earlier, the effectiveness has been about 90% or higher, which are very high numbers for a vaccine. These numbers are on par with the measles vaccine and just below the polio vaccine effectiveness. The flu vaccine effectiveness is at best 40 to 60%. Is the virus really 90 to 95% effective? The numbers the vaccine makers are showing are very impressive, especially since this has been done only in this year. Typically, it takes years to go through these trials, but we're in the middle of a pandemic and we need quick answers and quick solutions without compromising safety. Hopefully, the effectiveness of COVID-19 vaccines will match their impressive efficacy in clinical trials. However, we do not know how this information will translate when millions and millions of people will get the vaccine, and if the actual effectiveness may prove to be lower. So what side effects and possible warnings would you expect? Six facts versus myth. Number one, just summarizing, in less than 10% of the participants, the main side effects were fatigue, joint pain, headache, muscle pain, feeling warm, sore arm, low-grade fever. Some people's fatigue was described as more profound, and some people might miss perhaps a day of work and might need a day of rest. Point two. Messenger RNA vaccines have never been used commercially in the past. This is a new technology, highly effective, but still new. Vector vaccines, on the other hand, have been around for a long time and are well studied. Number three, you have to also remember that no vaccine is 100% effective, so you can still get the disease, but a milder version of it. After vaccination, it takes a couple weeks, usually 2 to 3 weeks, for your body to build an immunity. You could get infected just before or even after you receive the vaccination. As explained earlier, this is because it takes a couple of weeks for your body to build antibodies. Number four, currently none of the vaccines which are being developed in the US use live virus. There are other kinds of vaccines being developed, such as protein-based vaccines from Sanofi and Novavax. I can talk about them in later videos. Number five, once you get vaccinated, the vaccine will not cause you to have a positive viral test. This is because viral tests are used to test current infection. There's, however, the possibility that the antibody test will test positive, indicating a previous infection. This indicates that you have a level of protection from the virus. Number six, currently the recommendation is to get the vaccination even if you have been sick with COVID-19. The reason being is that there is some evidence that our natural immunity for this virus does not last long. This natural immunity is different from person to person. The other reason to get vaccinated is the risk of reinfection remains a possibility. And if you're interested in a video examining how you can tell the difference between COVID-19, the flu, and the common cold, click on this link above. And if you're interested in other videos, click right here or click right here and subscribe, and have a good day and think your health. This channel is about tips and advice to promote your health and to keep you... Oh my God, why can't I say this? Okay. Oh God. Okay, let's see how this goes.